Africa Skills Hub in partnership with Canada World Youth and Global Affairs Canada are implementing a 12-month pilot women entrepreneurship and livelihood initiative seeking to address the increasing inequalities that women in sub-Saharan Africa continue to face due to rising levels of COVID-19 pandemic. The intervention consists of a four-pronged approach. 1. COVID and SBV grassroots advocacy across the Sanargu district, northern Ghana. 2. Entrepreneurship scale-up through a gender-focused food and beverage incubator. 3. Access to markets initiative. And 4. Policy influencing.
For this incubator, it has really, really benefited me a lot. With what I've learned here, I'm currently working on my business plan for my business because I didn't have it before and I didn't know what it entailed to actually come up with one. But now I'm working on one and I'm very glad. Another benefit I've derived is that I have a certain network that I can rely on if I need support, because some of the women here have amazing products and I'm looking forward to doing business with them.
When we went into it 1 month, 2 months, I have never missed it. I always make sure I come to attend to it. When I came in, I didn't know so many things, but the incubator has taught me a lot, especially when the food and drug people came to teach us a lot about what we are supposed to do before manufacturing everything will come out into the market. They made me know about good manufacturing practices, where I'm supposed to site my factory, how I'm supposed to produce my products, how I'm supposed to lay them in order before everything, the labeling. And then I was taught book management, how to manage my book, how to keep records, how to draw my plan, business strategies. And it has helped me a lot. I'm into Ankisiwai Special Tom Brown. It sells in Kumasi and Accra more than in Tamale here. But because of the training and what I learned, now the business is better even in Tamale too, as compared to the Accra and Kumasi own. We are about 100 women here. And since I joined, my network has just expanded because some of them bought the product, tested, and it's good for them. So, and they are selling it for me now. So it has helped me a lot.
Before I joined the incubation, I didn't know how to do my labels well. For instance, I was doing my labels without badge number, barcode, and other things on the label. But when I joined the incubation, now I know that it is important to have all that on your label. And secondly, Food and Drugs Authority. I didn't know that when you don't have certain things on your labels, you cannot send your product there. And the necessary things that you should have before you send your products, through this incubation, I've been able to know all that. Also, we also know how to market our products digitally. At first, I didn't know. Like to market on Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, and all that. But now that I have joined the incubation, I know all of that.
Our unique integrated approach to women's economic empowerment has been tested through the selection of regions with existing high rates of SGBV exacerbated by the pandemic. Research statistics show that both the Volta and northern regions of Ghana boast some of the highest statistics of sexual violence, domestic slavery, unpaid farm labor, teenage pregnancy, and entrenched patriarchal beliefs. The communities featured in this video under WELI were selected according to the Vulnerability Index of the District Assembly. A few of our approaches to resolving SGBV in communities have consisted of various dialogues and sensitization on interpersonal communication for safe sex negotiation, male engagement strategy, reinforcement of young women network, and a marketplace for graduates of the Suyini Food and Beverage Incubator, to name a few.
Guys, you know, African skills are.